What is up, guys? It is Mercifies here. Today is lesson number 11 of our Java series of tutorials. And today's lesson is going to be focusing on creating an object of a class. Now, we haven't created objects in the past. And basically what that is allows us to transfer data from one class to another. We've used objects that have been included in the past, but we haven't created any objects of our own. So today we're going to do that. So I'm just going to go through here and delete all of those. And we're going to start out by creating a new class. And this is going to be called main class. So the main class is going to consist, it's not going to have this public static void main string args, because we're not going to be doing our testing in this class. We're going to be calling this class to do testing by itself. So to do that, we're going to have constructors. Now constructors are, they look a little bit like this. It's just public and then the name of your class, which is in this case main class. Now constructors, there's two kinds of constructors. You have your default constructor, which doesn't have anything inside of the parentheses and just looks like a normal method with nothing in the parentheses, no return type, none of that. And then you have your other constructor, which is an overloaded constructor. And this allows you to call main class, but it allows it to take parameters. So I'm going to, let's see, today's tutorial is going to be focused around I don't know. What's today's tutorial? We're going to figure out the average. So we're going to have two private integers, actually double. Double one, private double two. Okay. So in majority of cases, your default constructor will be used to put in what you want the default to be for your variables. So we're not going to pass anything to double one and two in this constructor. We're just going to set them to a specific number. So we're going to set 1 to 0 and 2 to 0. Okay. Now in your other constructor, your overloaded constructor, you can put in information in the parameters. This information is usually information that you're going to be passing to the class when you create it. So we want to pass two doubles, 1 and 2, and we want to set 1 and 2 to those doubles. Now there's two ways to do this. You can do double A, double B, and then set 1 equals A, 2 equals B. Or you can change it so it's the same as your primitive data types up here, so 1 and 2, and then you just type in this.1 equals 1, this.2 equals 2. Now if I have these parameters, and this goes to any kind of method that you have, if I have the parameters up top that are same as private or public parameters that you have throughout the entire class, this dot that parameter refers to the parameters that are private or public that are accessible throughout the rest of the class, whereas just the name one refers to the parameters being passed in referring to the parameters being passed, so things in the parentheses. So and then we want to create a method that's going to do the calculation. So we're going to have a return type on this method. It's going to be returning a double, public double get average. I keep doing that. Now when it comes down to return types, if you're going to be getting information, when you look at the name of it, you might say get set etc. Get average, set average, get number, set number, blah, blah, blah. Basically, get refers to returning a data type, so it has to have return inside of the method itself. So if we were trying to get the average, we're going to return a number, 1 plus 2 divided by 2. If we were trying to set these two numbers, after we've already created the class, we could do public set numbers, public void set numbers, set num, and then we want double 1, double 2. Again, because when you're setting information, you're passing information to this class. So we're going to, again, do what we did up here in the constructor, the overloaded constructor, but this is in case we want to update that data that we set up here. So if we set this 1 to 30 and 2 to 30, we want to change it to 30 and 40, we can just call upon setNum. So this dot 1 equals 1, this dot 2 equals 2. Okay, so we have this class which does all of our work for us, and we're going to save that class, and we're going to create a new class which is going to be our tester class. So we're going to call this tester class, and this class is going to contain the public static void main string args. So we're going to delete what we got there, and then we're going to create a new object. Now to do this, you type in the name of the class, main class. Usually your classes should be in capital, just so capitalized, just so you can differentiate them from data types. But main class, then what you want to refer to this object as, you can call this object anything. If I wanted to call this obj1 equals new main class, and then we're going to pass two data types. So our doubles, our two doubles will be passed through this. So we're going to pass I got 100 on a test and an 80. I want to see what the average is. And then we're going to do the semicolon at the end. Now, to return the daddy types, the daddy types, to return this average, we're going to call getAverage. So, obj1.getAverage, and then the semicolon. And that's going to, we actually have to put that in a system out print line because it's just returning a number. Print line get average. Okay, so if we compile this, something went wrong there. Something went wrong. Try this again. Compile that. There we go. We got a 90. All right. Forgot to put parentheses in there. It calls get average after we've passed the two parameters 180 to this class. Your tester class usually doesn't have anything but public static void main in it, and then it calls all your other classes. So let's say we want to update this average and change it to 190. We're going to do obj1.setNum, is it? I spelled that wrong. obj1.setNum, and we're going to set 190 as our 2. And then we're going to do another system out print line, obj1.getAverage. Average. Alright, compile it. Got a 90 and a 95 the second time. So that's how you instantiate objects, how you call upon other classes. I hope you guys enjoyed this lesson. If it didn't make any sense to you, let me know. Message me. If anything in these tutorials troubles you or bothers you, or you don't understand something, message me and I will reply to you as soon as possible and answer your question, hopefully. I hope you guys enjoyed. Like, favorite, subscribe, do what you gotta do. See you guys.